Let's say you've got $10 because you're a poor student. A dollar of that is going towards textbooks and materials because college is a scam. You've got $2 going towards Chipotle and Domino's and Chick-fil-A and all that delicious food that you don't really need to get. You've got $3 going towards bars and other weekend activities that you don't need to partake in. And that leaves $3 for movies, video games, and other Amazon impulse buys and Instagram ads that you can't resist. That's $1 left over at the end of the week. But let's say with some simple meal prepping and buying used instead of new, you get that back up to $3. Now imagine that this is $30, so just 3 times 10 because this is a fictional world. So say you have $30 left over at the end of each week and you invest that. Now over the course of a year, that $30 invested every week is about $1,564. If you invest that well, that could easily be $1,850 by the end of the year. Now let's say in the second year, instead of $30 a week that you put away, it's $35 a week. So while you've saved $1,500 in the first year and $1,800 in the second year, you have the interest from the original money the first year, you have the compounded interest of that original money in the second year, and then you have the interest of the money in the second year, or the investment, the portfolio increase. So that $3,400 that you set aside and invested is now looking at something like $4,100, or a $700 gain just by essentially doing nothing, just saving and investing. That $700 could be $1,400 of gain, or of course it could be zero as well. That's the stock market. Now in the last 2.5 years that I've been investing, I've had over a 60% return on investment for my portfolio. By investing in smart companies such as Apple and Nvidia and Target, I've seen awesome gains with some of my stocks more than doubling in their value, over 100% return. I've made a video talking about 6 practical tips for how you can get started investing, and I'll leave that link down below and you can click one of the cards up here. So with that 60% return on investment, if we look at the original example of $30 a week for year one and $35 a week for year two, that $3,500 would be something closer to $5,500, which is amazing. And for all students out there, I mean, come on, you gotta get on this. Now, of course, I'm talking about the US stock market here. I don't really know anything about any other country's stock market, but if you're a student in the United States or you have access to the United States stock market, it's a really, really good way of building wealth, of saving money, and just making sure that your money is working towards you so you can pay off your student loans, so you can go on that vacation, so you can have a life outside of college. So in this video, I'm just gonna go through 2 simple ways that you can start investing your money as a student, 2 ways that I do on top of many other methods, which I'm going to do and talk about in a video pretty soon. But let's talk about 2 ways that you can start investing and making money right now from the stock market. So my favorite and the easiest to recommend is Acorns. Now Acorns is an app that basically just takes money from your account, from your savings account or checking account, and automatically deposits into its app and invests it for you. So if you don't know anything about the stock market, this is great. Or even if you do know something about the stock market, like I know some things, I can still use this app really well because it just takes money that I'm not going to be spending and invests it. So you can choose between daily, weekly, and monthly or one-time contributions. So for instance, I have it set up to invest $15 a day into my account, and this is just money that I'm not going to be spending, so why not invest it? So it takes that $15 a day from my savings account and puts it into this app, and then I get to choose what kind of portfolio I want. Now I have it set on the most aggressive model because I'm an aggressive investor and I trust the stock market, and I think that there's no reason not to be aggressive. So this is going to be a mix of large, medium, and small company stocks, as well as some international stocks. But you can also choose moderately aggressive, moderate, moderately conservative, and finally conservative. So if you're kind of scared or paranoid about the stock market, you can always choose one of these safer options. But I've done the aggressive option, and basically just from taking money from my account that I wasn't going to be spending, so my savings account, my debit card, I've seen over a 12% return in about 7 months this year. So I've gained about, $300 this year just from doing nothing. Now, there is like a dollar monthly fee associated with this app, but I think it's well worth it because of its clear results. So I've gained $278 just from investing money automatically that I wasn't going to spend. And that's why I really like Acorns. I'll go more in depth on this in a future video because there's a lot more features and ways to save money. And shameless plug, if you use the link down in the description to sign up for Acorns, I think we both get $5, which is great and helps out the channel. Now the second method would be to open up your own brokerage account. So I've got one with Charles Schwab, and that's what I use for all my transactions, and that's got 99% of the money that I invest. But I think the easiest one for most people would just be Robinhood. And again, you can open up an account using my link and my code, and we'll both get a free stock out of it. But with that, it's very simple to just put money into exactly what you want. So if you want to invest into Apple or Tesla, because in a few days their stocks are gonna get much cheaper with a split, or you wanna put it into an index fund like Vanguard VTI to just kind of get the benefits of the entire market, which is much safer than an individual stock, whatever you wanna do. If you wanna put money into a specific stock or a specific index fund, something like Robinhood will let you do that, and it's very simple. You put in $100, you say, okay, I want to invest a partial share into Apple, or I want to put money into Microsoft. You are able to do that, and then you can watch it go up and down and up and down. Of course, you probably shouldn't check it every day unless you're a day trader. If you're someone that's just looking for long-term results, which by the way, long-term results are always better than short-term results. So if you're wanting to let your money just ride and in a few years take it out, don't look at it too often, but Robinhood and other portfolios like this are a great way to start investing money as a student. So again, I definitely recommend investing money if you are a student. Basically, if you can make more money or spend less money, all that extra can be invested and that can just work for itself. It's one of the safest and easiest ways of wealth development in the United States. I definitely recommend it to anybody out there. If you're looking for more investment advice, Graham Stephan's channel is one of my favorites. I'll leave that linked down below. And again, I recommend Acorns and something like Robinhood. And pretty soon I'll have another video talking about a bunch of different ways that you can invest and make money in the stock market. So look out for that. But good luck investing. Leave any comments or questions you have down in the comment section and I'll get back to you. Thanks for watching.